Okay, let's look at this ridge-like bar and talk about it a little bit. This is a structure situation, and so let me go over a little bit and chat just a little bit. I'll go out here and point out some features that's on the ridge-like bar or around this ridge-like bar. Right here, I'm approaching a wash that comes off of the side of the hill. From you may not be able to see it like I can see it, but you see that stump sticking up. The wash came down through there. Up there on the top, there's little grooves and so on, and it comes right down through here. And this wash off of here has produced this big flat. That's wash in, and you see the flat. Now that can immediately tell us that the fish that are moved toward this structure or move up on this bar are not going to come from this side. They're just not going to do it. They're not going to cross that flat. You can see the flat. Now, on this bar, here is some break lines. Nice break line coming right off the side of this bar, right up to this wash right here. And as I go out and walk out this break line, I'm going to come to some features that we want to be sure we understand. Out here's a stump. That stump is right on the side of the bar. If you see it, there's another one up there. This is a break. This is a structure. All of this thing is a structure situation, which tells me that this has potential of becoming a productive piece of the bottom. The structure is the bottom. This stump is a break on this structure. I'm going to move out. It's a little to the side just a little bit, but that's all right. Right here, I'm coming up to another one. That is another bunch of stumps. It's lying a little bit up on the side of the break line. You can see the ridge-like bar up there. Now I come to another one that is right on the break line. It starts breaking good right here. It breaks some there, but it starts breaking right here. And here is a stump, which is a break on this break line. If you remember your study material, one of the most productive spots is a break on a break line. So I hope you picked that up in your study material. And I'll tell you the reason why in just a minute. Let's go out here and see if we can pick up where the contact point on this structure. I'm going to move up on the ridge, and I'm going to look at it. Right here, it drops off the bar, the ridge-like bar that we're talking about going up through the yonder. It kind of drops off on this side, and we got a little finger. It kind of bends. We got a little finger. I don't know whether you can see that or not, but it's sitting right down there, and this comes right up on it like this, and then right on up there. That would be the contact point. Not down there, not over here. She drops off over here. Right down there. Come right on up here. Now when they get in this area, are they going to go up on the ridge? No. The break line starts right there. That's just a little ridge. Boom. It come along here. I want to stress this next point here. Move along. I said they. I'm assuming this is a school of big bass. I wouldn't have to assume it because this structure looked like it produced something like that. Come right along this break line. It keep moving along pretty good. Slow, but keep moving. until they got here. Now when they got here, they're gonna pause here or stop. It could be that the weather and watercolor is such that this is as far as they come. They stay at these breaks right here, then turn around and go back downstairs. But so let's assume that they stop here, they case the joint, everything looks fine, they adjust to the light conditions and things, and so they start moving again. There'd be some out here that they're moving right on up here. I'm one of these fish. I'm the daddy of those fish. I'm the big boy of the fish. I'd keep moving. Some would stop right there, stop right there. Here would be a school of bass. I move on up here. Slowly moving up here. It'd be some that stay around this thing, and that's so close I'm sure that this would be a stopping point. Some of them would there. There's another break. Maybe the weather's condition was such that they started down there, came up there, paused a while, then came up to this spot. Okay, things are pretty good. The weather and water stable. So I'd move it. I'd come right on up here. Now, I would come on up, but still follow that break line until I got to that wash. I'd pause. That, I wouldn't go that way. That's kind of just like that. This wash stops. Then here goes the wash up here. Even there's another little break right there that they could eyeball. They go right on up that little wash right up on there. And come on up here. Now the water level is way up above my head now. Come right on up this little wash, and I could see this hump. I'm walking up on the hump now. Drops off on that side. I'm walking, starting up the hump. And when I got right here, most likely I would say, okay boys, whoa, back up. We're getting a little bit too shallow here. We could say that according to where the weather is. But another thing, regardless how far it's up on this thing is up and how much farther they go, this would be a stopping place, concentration of fish, because it won't go down the back side of that thing, down in yonder, to get the shallow water. It doesn't make sense to them, it doesn't make sense to me, that I have to go downhill to get the shallow water. Now you say, how's the best way to find this thing? How am I gonna know all that stuff is there? My water level never drops. It always stays pretty constant. How am I gonna do that? Well, your depth sounder will show you a little bit, but your depth sounder moving around like with like an electric motor, moving around very slowly, you wouldn't map this feature in a coon's age that way. No way. But we got a teacher, and we're gonna do it fast, and we're gonna do it by trolling. I don't know how long it'd take you to find this out by casting. Could take you a week. And most likely you'd make a few casts and then you'd say, ah, that's not biting, and you'd head off somewhere else. But this is the teacher, the trawler. Let's imagine the water is up here above my head. I control every bit of that. It's my teacher. I control the bar. I can hit it from several directions. As soon as I look at it, I'd be trolling right down that break line. I'd come and I'd bump my lures off of those stumps. And I'd come up here and I'd come up and I'd move it. I could see it, I could feel it. I could feel the breaks and things. Cause I see the ridge-like bar sitting here. I'm not gonna go off down that way. I'm gonna work this side of it, or I'm gonna work that side of it. So in trolling, not only would I find the shape of this thing, the depth of this thing, I'd find the areas where this pause or stop. I'd find the route, that's what I'd find. After I did that, then I could cast. You could anchor the boat somewhere out here, cast across and work this hump. Fan cast it and keep fan casting down here. Right on down that thing. Cause this is the way they're gonna go back. And I anchor my boat right down there, I'll stop it, and I cast that brake line. I cast it all the way out. Cast that brake line all the way. I'd be sure that I got my lures down next to that stuff. Then I'd move my boat out there toward the end, and I'd fan cast that bar. Now, if I didn't reach the fish, and I saw that the weather was okay, the watercolor was okay, there's only one thing for me to do after I did that. I troll it, I cast it, and that's to wait for them to move. Once or twice on an average fishing day, the fish will become active and may move toward the shallows. One day, the weather may be such that they wouldn't move to the top out there where I first started. Then the weather may get in one time you get here, the weather and waters are such that as far as they come would be those breaks, those stumps. Then another time you might come in the migration, the weather and water condition would be up to here, this wash. And then under good, cloudy, warm front type conditions with a lot of good watercolor, right there. That may not occur very often, but when it moves to that hump, you can guarantee that you're going to have a bunch of them. There ain't going to be one, it's going to be a bunch of them. And I hope you see how you'd work a bar. Now, if you don't have the brake line on the bar, then of course you got to work right up on the ridge, but you got to look for the points. You see the fishable spots, bang, 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 bang. Keep this in mind. That's the way those things work. And now we're going to look at some other features too. And I hope the water will be low enough that I can visualize and walk them and become a fish again for you. In this case, we're going to talk about another brake line, but in this instance, we're going to call it a sharper brake. And a sharper brake is where there's a more rapid increase in depth than the surrounding area. This is a picture of a big bar. It shows contour lines of 5 to 10 to 15, 20. In other words, what it means is that at this depth is 10 feet. At this depth, it's 15 feet. As you look at this bar, most of it is just pretty wide, flat distance between it. But at one point, the contour lines come close together. In other words, the increase in depth becomes more rapid, and it's for just a short distance, too. This is a sharper break. It broke sharper, deeper, faster at this point. And in most all situations, that's going to be your contact point. Anytime the parallel lines on a contour map comes close together, that is a sharper break right there. And so you may not even have this big bar, but all these parallel lines just coming around like this, all the way around the lake. But somewhere on there, you'll see I'm swinging close together. And then you go, that is a sharper break right there. And this is the area of which you've got to concentrate your effort. Well, we're going to look at another feature, a bar. This bar is a long, round bar that has springers on it. And it's like the structure, bars and things that you find in a lot of natural lakes. In fact, it might be about the only feature in a natural lake. There's a great big flat, kind of flat, rounded bar-like, going around a point. And on it, you'll have fingers that go out. Now, we're going to look at it, at something here. It comes around here. There's the bar, the big bar. It just keeps going out and out and out and goes down. Now, what I want you to do, and where we're looking at it now, I want you to look at a brake line out here. Now, when you see that brake line, now that is what we're going to call a sharper brake on this big bar. And just a little bit later, we're going to go up on top and we're going to look down and see where the fish and the importance of the sharper brake. And in your study material, I brought this out many, many times, that the sharper brake is a very important thing to the fish. What I mean by a sharper brake, it increases in depth more rapidly. In other words, it could be just as the one you're looking at, could be just about straight up and down. Whereas if you look back this way just a little bit toward that thump on that sharper, that brake line, you'll see when you come to me, I'll point out where we got a brake line, but it's not as steep as that. Right in here, you see where it starts breaking, coming down into here? See, now the fish this wouldn't be important to those fish. But that sharper brake is important. We're going to go up, but before we go up on top, let me walk out toward that point and point out a few things about where I think how the fish would move up to this sharper brake. Then we'll move up on top and give you a better perspective of what we're talking about. This is kind of flat coming off of this big bar. A brake line around there, but just about the time you get to that stump, that brake on it, it just about peters out. It just kind of goes like this. But that could be important. I don't know whether we can see it from this angle, but we'll see it on top angle. The fish that make contact could probably come in right there, or they could come in out there at that other rock. I'd have to check out there. But they would move to this sharper break, regardless whether they came in there, because I don't know really what's out there. I haven't trolled it and looked at it. It could come up right in there, maybe where the stump is, that tree in the water. They could come right up there to that rock, and right here's a sharper break. Plenty of stuff is very close. They'd have no problem seeing that sharper break. They could move up on this bar just a little up here. A lot of times they may hit there, move along this sharper break. Now they didn't come up out there. It broke off. We got a brake line here, and then they move along this brake line till they come up to that stump. Then at that point, they might move up on the structure. But they wouldn't make contact out there. They'd make it at this sharper break. In your study material, I think you've seen the very thing, and I pointed this thing out. But they come here, and this sharper break, this gives the fish immediate access back to deep water. That's the important thing. When I look at, if I was a fish, this is the way I'd look at it. This tells me that if I move up here, and I'm moving up on this sharper break, and I get up there. Now I'm getting in hazardous country up there. I don't want to have to go a half a mile to get back deep water. This sharper break is important because I can immediately get back to deep water. And this would be the contact point. This is sharper break, not sharp out there. And as we get on top, you'll see it petering out completely around on the top part of this bark. So let's go up on top and take a look at it. And let's look at this big bar. Now this is a great big bar. Now this particular one has a lot of rocks and things on it, but if you're in a natural lake, a lot of natural lakes, this is going to be a situation you're going to run into all the time. It may be sandbars and it may be some weeds up yonder, but it'll run out toward the deeper water that you've already located a hole out there. And this, so we've got to do it. We know the fish are going to come from that deep water out there. So let's pan and look. Let's look at this. Just scan this bar. See it coming around this great big bar? And it could be even flatter than what we're looking at, but this shows you that it's dropping off. Going all the way around, and then come over here, and I'm gonna show you, and come right on around until you're sure you got all this feature right in here. Now I'm gonna go down here and toward this sharper break. And I think you got a pretty good picture of how this, we scanned it over here, how it was just all, bar just went all out and didn't do too much, a few rocks and things, a couple little fingers on it. And you come across here, over on one side, to what we called a sharper break. Now, if you were trying to locate in a natural lake, the sharper break, and you were only using an electric motor or you were rowing, you'd probably never find that sharper break. You gotta be moving if you're using a depth sounder. If you don't have a depth sounder, you gotta get some spoon plugs down there to feel it and feel the shape of this thing. And so you can locate the sharper break. So that means in the trolling, even if you don't have a lure in the water, the speed of the boat will show you contours. You can't contour it, you can't see the shape of this thing, the brakes and all that stuff and how it's shape of it, if you're rowing around with a depth sounder, or if you got an electric motor going around looking with a depth sounder. You'd never interpret the structure. But the trolling pattern will do something different. Now I'm going to become a fish again. Now at this sharper break, I'm going to come in where I thought it'd rise up, and I still think it'd come up right over there. I'm going to go down here and become a fish. I don't know whether you can hear me or not. Well, I'm gonna move along this shore. I'm gonna move along this break line. And if you can't hear me, well, that's okay too. But you be looking, and I'm gonna show you something. Okay, I'm gonna fish, and I'm gonna move. I came and made contact down here, and I'm coming up, and here's my sharper break right here. I'm gonna move along this sharper break. Then I'm gonna move up on it a little bit. And I'm still gonna move along this here break line. And then all at once, before I got around here, this brake line, so I'll go up on the bar any farther. This is as far as I'm gonna go. Doesn't look so good up there to me. And then all at once here comes something, and I want to get back to deep water. Shoo! I'm in the sanctuary from all this dangerous area up here, so to speak. I wouldn't come up down there. I'd come up here where I come up and case the joint, and I immediately get back to deep water. Let's say I came up way down there and I moved up the Younger. I'm too far. That's a long route on a bar like this. But right here, I can get back. The sharper break. You look on a bar that goes around, you got a finger that breaks the deepest with a sharper break, there's your contact point. So we'll look at some other stuff. Now if you want to look around, follow me, let's say that I move up here. I wouldn't get too far from this break line, this sharper break on this big bar. I'd move on up here. I'm getting a little bit shallower all the time, but I'm still got a sharper break right there. A sharper break's right here. And I come around this thing, and here's where I pause. I might go up on here just a little bit, but my sharper break, my break just about petered out right here, but here's my sharper break, and right there, I'm down into the deep water again. I bet you at the high water mark, it'd be a real hot spot right here. Somebody else found that the hot spot. Let me show you. Probably found it by accident. He's probably a crappy fisherman. He put in a cedar tree here and he marked it. But I bet you any amount of money, he didn't know why this was a hot spot. He came drifting with minnows or something, and when he got right here, he started catching some crappie. So he sunk him up weed there. Probably didn't even know the stump was there. But he found it. I'd like to talk to that fella. Let's go and become a fish on a different type structure, okay?